Hello everyone, my name is Louis, the editor. Before my groupmates start, let us change the color first. There we go, and now sit back and try to relax as we dive in.
The history of San Diego Pro Cathedral, Silay. The parish of Silay was established in 1776. Its first church was built out of light materials, bamboo, coconut grass, and nipa palm. During the time of Gobernador Silio Alejo Severino's administration, Padre Alejo Ignacio D. Mulenas, a Spaniard, was his first priest. In 1841, then, parish priest Father Eusebio Luxin initiated the construction of a more permanent structure, made out of stone and wood. The roof was improved through the use of galvanized iron. Further improvements were done, but when the revolution broke out in November 5, 1898, the church was left unfinished. In 1925, work began on a grander structure meant to replace the old church. Don Jose R. Desma, a resident of Silay in the wealthy sugar baron, donated a substantial portion of the funds needed to build the new edifice. The rest of the money was raised throughout the popular contribution, including fundraising for school children. Don Jose R. Ledesma commissioned an Italian architect, Lucio Bernasconi, to design the new church. Bernasconi was also responsible for the design and construction of the Silay War, which was raised by the Imperial Japanese soldiers during the Second World War. Bernasconi taught the churches in his native Italy as the model of the Silay Church. The church's layout shape of a Latin cross, with a cupola rising 40 meters above the nave. Construction was completed in 1927, and the new church was inaugurated the same year.
What are its distinct architectural features? The Silay City Parish Church at Silay City, Negros Occidental, Philippines is an impressive structure that amplifies a strong Spanish colonial influence in its architecture. The name of the architect is Lucio Bernasconi, an Italian architect, was responsible for the design of the new structures. He took the magnificent churches in Italy as the inspiration for the Silay Church. Hence, the architectural designs of the structure is Romanesque in style. It features a large nave, semicircular apse, and a bell tower that stands approximately 65 feet tall. The exterior of the church is constructed from coral stone, featuring intricately carved stones along the facade. The church also has a number of distinct architectural features, including multiple tiers of buttresses, recessed balconies, a bahay na bato inspired a facade, and a stunning wooden crucifix over the entrance. Inside, one will find stunning work of art, such as beautiful retablo depicting scenes from the life of Jesus. Additionally, the church features several distinct elements of Baroque architecture, such as distinct curved roof and numerous arch windows. The church is also home to several important artworks, including an impressive painting of the Last Supper. The Silay City Parish Church stands in a unique location that was once the site of a rich cultural heritage, making it an inspiring venue for the religious ceremonies. Finally, the church has withstood the test of time, still standing tall after more than a century and representing a remarkable example of colonial architecture from the Philippines.
have a lot of likes and dislikes about the design of the church. But one thing that we, the group, have found our likings to the church is that it's well designed of the glass. Before you enter the San Diego Cathedral, you will notice a circular glass on top of the door. You can't miss it because it is very huge. We have decided that all of us liked it. It's because to show and remember the ancient cathedral designs before we jump to modern designs. We liked it because it brings light inside the cathedral. No electric lights and no candle lights. Just a natural light source. But we don't like just one design. We also love its exterior, the way the cathedral places its history in the story of Jesus Christ. Their way of placing everything makes a well-managed cathedral. During our planning to the cathedral, we were sitting in front of the church when one of our group members was shocked in fear, because someone is staring at her. But it turns out, it's just a statue of Jesus Christ behind the glass. What glass, you say? The glass that we have mentioned earlier. We laughed because she was scared and told us what she saw. The outside design of the cathedral is very flawless to me, but my Silaynon groupmate said that it was his likings too. So we decided to add this in our list. As an Iskalantihanon, I am new to the church. My groupmates called me Manol, a Bisaya or Ilonggo term for culture shock. Because it's true, I am culture shocked to the place. But I love the cathedral.
The only church with a dome in the province is the San Diego Pro Cathedral. The church design is based on the Latin cross and it features a rose window. I also find it interesting that Jesus Christ is looking out the window at the church main entrance.
What do you think is the significance of or contribution of the building to the Negrense culture, which is specifically like ang church, ano ang do na bulig yas sa ato yung Negrense sa ang church na
ang church na
para
sa ato para malapit pa din ang tanan na tao sa Ginoo ng ilang kawalingon ni kung di nila ano di nila ihalag sa Ginoo hindi kay padayaw-dayaw kundi nga kung na kasi kung sa ikaw pa tao nga nagatuo nga medyo sa kalibutan ang imo balatya kung panguna-una mo ano sa Ginoo at sa imo isip ka tao pinaka-importante whatever you do kuno to the least of my brethren sinis ang Ginoo you do it to me sinis ang Ginoo. So kung maayo kita sa ato isip ka tao ang unang ginahimok ka na sa Ginoo tandaan mo simbahan amo ang dalangpan sa tanang sa
kabuhayan. Sa imo, ano ang napulig o ang importansya sa simbahan sa ato ng mga Negrense?
Building niya atang pa'y balong party sa atang malo, di ba? Tapos para kung isa na kadaan po niya, kaya makita ko ang tao ang kapataan na po niya ka na ngayon Kristiyano. Kaya sunda mo man gatin ni sa isa pagkatapos mo nilo niyo sa dilang ikan. Pero at least ako siya po ng simbahan na tapos kaya po niya. Yung katoliko na ginaya.
Simulan ko, ano kinang pinaka-nagulig yung pala sa ato? Ang though, anong na-contribute is ato niya kapuhi na abugin na siya ka-importante para sa ato pinasahipan.
Siyempre, yung pamuklat yung sa tao nga Kristiyano, kailang Kristiyano ka, hindi siyempre mo ano na, ang Bible na muna isa na nagagay, muna yung permita pinamisa eh. Mga birth, kapal na muna yan, muna nagagalan sa mga mga chapter. Ang mula na dapin niya ang pag-misa, mga ebanghelyo nila, ang mula na. Araw ko siya po sa Bible. Pero at least nga panunto ng tao. Ako makakating sa misa.
Video kita.
The San Diego Pro Cathedral is the center of Catholic faith in Silay City. San Diego Pro Cathedral is the only church in Negros Occidental with a dome. This church exists primarily to proclaim the Word of God that is so desperately needed by everyone still living. This church also exists to provide men the opportunity for fellowship with other believers. Lastly, the San Diego Pro Cathedral exists to provide a place for a corporate worship of the living God, though we should certainly worship privately and often. We should, as far as possible, stay in prayer.